Hey SnowRunner fans, in this video we're going to look at the Ranger US-K23, a military truck. If you find this video entertaining or helpful, please take a moment to subscribe, like, and share. Thank you. So as I said, this is a military truck and you can see the customizations that I've made to it along the left as I slowly scroll through them. You'll also see the power to weight ratio, the durability, and the fuel consumption, along with the fuel capacity, which is not outstanding on this truck. The RNG comes from part of the pseudonym Ranger of the person who modded this particular truck, or created this particular truck. So the first thing we're going to do with this truck is take it to the mud pit just outside of Blacksmith, Michigan. Sorry, Black River, Michigan. Smithville, Black River. Nah, there we go, Black River. So you see this has pretty good tires. And even though I don't have the diff lock on or any other assistance, it seems to be making its way through here quite nicely. And the one thing that I like about this truck especially is that it not only is a military vehicle, it actually looks like a military vehicle the way I've got it tricked out with the canopy and stuff. It looks pretty good. Looks like if it drove down your street, you'd be like, yeah, that's a military vehicle. So we've come out the other side of the mud pit in probably near record time, especially among the mid-size off-roads, I'm guessing. Seems to have handled itself very nicely here. Now we'll head on out to the quarry just outside of Smithville Dam. The quarry is a good test for trucks. I've had a couple of them flip over on me and some of them get stuck. And they'll get stuck to the point where sometimes I can't even rescue them and I have to actually recover them from this quarry. So it doesn't necessarily look especially tough, but it's pretty tough on the trucks. A little trying on drivers as well, in my humble opinion, of course. Your mileage may vary. So we're down part of the way into the quarry. Pardon me. And we're gonna go around the side. Find the ramp down to the bottom, which is just up here on the right, a little further up. You see a lot of these trucks say they have military roots, but they've probably been somewhat domesticated. This one seems to me like it's still a military-grade vehicle. I was going to take the shortcut, but looks like I'm prevented from doing so by means of a lowish front bumper. No worries, we can go around. Front wheel's off the ground and everything. This truck has a fair bit of torque. And an awesome sound, by the way. So now that we've circled around, we'll attack the shortcut from the other side. And then take that same ramp back up. Work our way up out of the quarry. This can be tricky though, because usually if a truck is going to spill going over the shortcut, it's on the way out, not on the way in. The Ranger looks like it's doing really well. Or should I call it the M-23? Who thinks of the names for these things anyway? 7385. Anyway. Looks like we got ourselves stuck in a little box here. We did make it across the shortcut and we haven't flipped, but we haven't got it quite turned around to the point where we can get back up the ramp here. Just a little bit further, that'll do it. Now we'll put it back in low, add the diff lock, give us a little help getting out of here, and climb on up. Let's go. There we go. Altogether, I'd have to say this truck handled itself pretty well down here, except for that part of getting stuck there, which is really more my fault than that of the truck. And despite how tough that shortcut can be on the way out, it handled itself admirably, only getting locked in for a moment until it fought its way out. Now we're hitting the second to last ramp on the way up out of here. Normally I would say this one's tough and some trucks have a hard time, but it looks like I would just be sounding crazy. Okay, and we're almost at the final ramp. Take us up to the road, out of the quarry altogether. Point us back towards Smithville Dam. To show off and put it in automatic and take the diff lock off for the last couple meters. There we go. Good job. Okay, so finally, last but not least, we're going to head for the current in the Yukon. This is a nice river. It sometimes surprises me which trucks have a hard time and which ones don't. Sometimes the off-road trucks don't do so well through here. Am I at the right current? This one just seems to be eating it up. Okay, well, no worries there. That was a quick ride. I wouldn't say record, but it was fast. So if you like this video, if you found it entertaining or helpful, please hit subscribe, like, and share. And in the meantime, stay safe and take care. And until the next video, bye for now.